The Hobbit is an adventure story, and the person who goes on the adventure is the Hobbit. He's rather bullied into it by a wizard who thinks he knows best. And no sooner has Gandalf cast his young friend Bilbo to accompany the dwarves on their quest, then he worries whether he's made the right decision or not, and he's constantly keeping a protective eye open to Bilbo's progress. But he senses, I think, that Bilbo is the person who is needed to help the dwarves accomplish their ends. He thinks it would be good for, as he says to Bilbo, for him to discover. Not discover things through books and maps, enjoyable as that is, but discover things on the road. Climb to the top of that mountain, have a look. In the book, The Hobbit, and in the film, Gandalf comes and goes. He's in the centre of the action, and then he withdraws. He's got a job to do. And in the film, we often find out what that job is. But he's in and out of the progression of the dwarves towards the mountain, and the treasure and the dragon. Inside Peter Jackson, you have to have an iron will, even though the outside is almost at times cuddly, always friendly, always helpful, always attentive, generally quiet. Well, he has the right temperament for the job. But yes, he's the facilitator. He makes things happen. He puts people together. He organizes. He's a commander. He's a soldier. He's got an overall view. He's a general.